Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with the new Hibernate tip. And today I want to show you how you can add additional filter criteria to a mapped association. You can use Hibernate's where annotation to define an SQL clause which filters the elements of a mapped association. It allows you to provide a native SQL fragment, which will be added to the where clause of the query that loads the associated entities. Let's take a look at an example. Books can be published in different formats, for example as an ebook or as a paperback. You can model that with a book entity and a format enum. Each book was written by one or more authors, so you need a many-to-many association between the book and the author entity. I modeled that as a typical many-to-many association on the book entity. You could, of course, do the same on the author entity. But let's say you want to use different associations for ebooks and physical books. In that case, you need to define two associations on the author entity and filter them accordingly. You can easily do that by annotating the attribute that maps the association with a where annotation. You then need to provide an SQL fragment as the value of the annotation's clause attribute. Hibernate adds this fragment to the where clause of the SQL statement. So here I can use that to map the association to two attributes that keep distinct lists of book entities. The where annotation of the ebooks attribute limits the association to the book entities with the format ebook, and the where annotation of the print books attribute checks that the book entities have the format paperback. When you now load an author entity and initialize the associations, Hibernate executes independent SQL statements to get the elements of the ebooks and print books association. And as you can see here, Hibernate uses the provided SQL snippet in the join clause of the query. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!